Hey Magical Sparks, welcome or welcome back to my channel. It's Sparkle here, and today I'm going to be sharing with you guys 10 fun and easy ways to make your already amazing sketchbook even more interesting. So let's get straight into this. So the very first step is to grab your sketchbook and grab your pencil, and now we're gonna start drawing. Be yourself, draw whatever you want. For the sake of this first tip, I'm just gonna draw a nice easy subject matter, which is going to be my desk plant flora. So pretty much for this step, go ahead and draw any kind of object or person or character or animal, like anything you want, and then comes the fun part. So this tip is to basically just take your drawing a step further and just make it kind of pop on your page. It's something that I like to selectively when I want to make a specific drawing on a page pop, and that is to add a very nice strong shadow behind your character, like this drawing for example. Okay, now here's my drawing, and we're going to try and take it just a step further. You can use a brush tip marker or just a normal marker, and you might have seen this technique being used a lot when it comes to calligraphy. For example, over here I've gone ahead and I've added black shadows to a specific side of each letter, which just makes it pop and look so cool. Same thing going on here as well. And now I'm going to try and kind of translate this idea onto my art. This idea is so customizable because you can use a black marker or you can use something completely different. You can use a different color, you can use a different art supply, and also you can either follow the laws of physics and earth and gravity by drawing shadows exactly where they would be if this was a real object, or you can be crazy and literally just outline your entire subject with a dark shadow. And to make it pop even more, you can go ahead and grab a gray marker or watercolors or pencils and just add a light shadow around your strong shadow. And there you go, this drawing is already popping on this page. I haven't tried this technique with a graphite sketch yet, but I'm actually kind of curious. Anyways, this is the very first idea, and with that done, it's time to move on to the second one, which requires us to fill in the sketchbook page first. Can you believe I made this sketch before Christmas, but I never got around to finishing it? I mean, that's a pretty long gap in between. Anyways, I would like to take the chance to explain that in no way is this video implying that your sketches have to look a specific way, or that your sketchbook has to look a specific way, and that if it looks any other way, that it's bad or wrong. That is not at all what this video is about. It's just to kind of give you some ideas about how you can make your sketchbook a bit more interesting, maybe add some variety and try different things. But in my opinion, I love, love, love messy sketchbooks. Sketchbooks do not have to be aesthetic. I mean, I'm the kind of person who likes to have some aesthetic pages, but mostly just self-expressive and messy pages. And that's pretty much what I want to share with my art as well. And in the end, I just wanted to make this video as kind of like a way to inspire other people, and nothing else like bad. It's not like meant to put you down or make you feel bad about your art, because I bet you that your art is amazing just the way it is, and it's going to get even better and better. And guess what? That officially brings us to technique number two, which is to include box colors. What I mean by this is just add a colorful box behind your character. You can pick the colors of the character's drawings, or you can pick a contrasting color or create a gradient or something. This is just a really fun way to make your favorite drawing pop out on the page. I think it's just a nice way to add color, fill in space, make that composition just look even more fancier. And here are some examples of how I do that. As you can tell, I do it a lot. I do it using markers, highlighters, watercolors. I just love it. It's lots of fun, and I would definitely recommend it. And if you want to take it just a step further, then technique number three is for you. So grab out a white gel pen and use it to create a white outline around your character. Now, I love using this technique in combination with the box color technique, especially when the background is nice and dark, because the gel pen pops out even more. Okay, now a nice alternative is to use a correction pen if you don't have a gel pen on hand. I pretty much like to squeeze it out to the side and then get it ready so I can use it on the actual drawing. And it pretty much works in a similar way, but it's just a tiny bit more difficult to manage than a gel pen for me. But once you get the hang of it, it's pretty easy. But let's say that you are not someone who wants to use a white gel pen or a correction pen. In that instance, you can just leave a natural outline around your drawing when you're adding the box colors, kind of like this. And yeah, it's just much easier. Or let's say that you are working on a white background and you want to add a white outline. In this situation, I'd recommend grabbing a shadow color. For example, I'm using a blue here, and outlining your character with that, making sure you leave a white gap in between. That way, it creates the illusion of your character having a sticker-like look. But in the end, I'd recommend going with whatever it is that works the best for you. And now this actually brings us to technique number four. So have you ever made a drawing and you want it to stand out, but you don't want to be too restrictive with how you make it stand out? Like you don't want to draw a box around it because that just feels too like stiff and not loose and fun? Well, if you're looking for something nice and loose and fun, then I recommend using watercolors. I love using watercolors, and in my opinion, watercolors are one of the best mediums because they're just so magical. And I love just adding splashes behind my sketches with watercolors. It's such a fun way to add a pop of color, but also be loose and fun. And watercolors are so convenient because you can take it on the go easily. You can use a water brush if you're in the great outdoors, and you can pretty much mix up almost any color you want. I mean, who wouldn't love that? Okay, yes, that is all good and fine and amazing and positive, but at the same time, there are some things that you do have to consider. For example, some sketchbooks are not exactly made to take watercolors or wet mediums, which means that the paper can either warp or it just can't hold the watercolors and create that beautiful effect like other papers do. If that is the case and your sketchbook just does not work well with watercolors, I would personally recommend using something else like highlighters or colored pencils just to add a loose pop of color behind your subjects. Okay, now here I was thinking about it. I was thinking about going with like a pink watercolor effect to contrast with the character, but at the same time, I kind of just want to give this page a nice blue theme. So I went with blue and I love it. And then I decided to try something nice and experimental, and I added some marker on top, and I love how this turned out as well. It's always so much fun just to like play around and have fun in your sketchbook, because after all, your sketchbook is your safe place. And with that, it's time for our next idea, which is something I like to call the masking tape effect. And it's super duper easy. All you're gonna do is just create the illusion of there being masking tape stuck on your sketchbook by drawing it. I usually find myself using this technique when I've filled in most of a sketchbook page, but I don't really know what to draw in a tiny portion of it. At these times, I like to kind of draw like a rectangle or a square and add masking tape on the edges and just kind of make a mini drawing inside it, which is pretty much exactly what's going on here. So in the bottom, I filled up the space by drawing an eye, and at the top, I filled up the space by drawing a teddy bear. And also, you can add some shading around the masking tape to make it look even more 3D. As you can see, I've sketched it over here in my previous sketchbook, and I feel like it's just a really cool way to combine like 2D and 3D elements at the same time. Like you're making a 2D drawing, but you're implying that it's 3D. I think that's pretty cool. And like I said, it's a great way to fill space, and it also kind of gives you a mini canvas to work on so you can make a nice quick little drawing while also filling the space. Also, if you have watched this far into the video, can I just say you are truly, truly amazing. Thank you so, so much. Comment this emoji down below to let me know you've been watching this far. Again, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And now here is how our final page turned out. I think it looks kind of cool, but don't worry, I kind of went in and fixed up some things afterwards, but watch until the end to find out. Also, we have a lot more sketchbook pages that we're gonna fill, so, you know, make sure to keep on watching. And now the next technique is a very kind of fun technique. Just grab something that is nice and straight and use it to draw a rectangle. Now within that rectangle, draw a square in the top half or the top two thirds. And then that's pretty much it. Well, that's pretty much all the preparation at least, because what we've gone ahead and drawn here is a retro photo print. And this is just another fun way to give yourself a nice small canvas to work on, a nice small space to work on, so that kind of like removes pressure. And now in this square that we have within our rectangle, go ahead and draw anything you want. For example, on this Halloween inspired page, I drew a bat. And on this Christmas page that I never finished, I drew a gingerbread man. So this one was kind of inspired by the idea of a new year, so I tried drawing a firework. It didn't work out that great, so instead I went ahead and drew this. Nice and simple, but it still works. But anyways, in the end, the idea is to pretty much draw a retro photo print, but you can draw whatever you want to be the actual photo. And that brings us to the next technique, which is to add more to your sketchbook using a metallic pen or metallic pens. For example, you can use it to add accents to your drawing like this, or to outline your characters, or to add some glowy effects on their outfits, or just to scribble and doodle and be yourself, just like I was doing here. Or you could try something a bit different like I was doing and use it to fill in the entire background, which, you know, also works too. But I find that using metallic pens in your sketchbook is just such a nice way to make them look fancy, because metallic pens look so, so beautiful in real life, because keep in mind, they're metallic and reflective and they make your sketchbook look like a jewel. Not just that, but metallic pens are also super satisfying to use. They're super satisfying to look at. They're fun and relaxing and therapeutic. And as you can tell, I am all for metallic pens because I personally love them a lot. And yeah, I would recommend trying them out if you haven't already done so. Okay guys, we are so close to the end. Three more ideas to go. And now for our third last idea, it is to create and place an envelope in your sketchbook. Envelope, envelope, protective piece of paper that letters are sent in, whatever it is that you want to call it, that's totally fine. But the idea is just to measure out the length and the width and make sure the measurements are all okay, as you can see me doing on screen right now, and get ready to make your own custom envelope. If you're not too sure how to create your own envelope, I'd recommend kind of going back and rewinding this video and watching it at a slower playback speed, or maybe there's a lot of good tutorials on YouTube as well that you can check out. But for me here, I was just kind of going with the flow and making things up as I go. And as you can see, it is gradually starting to come together. I have no idea why I decided to use a pink paper for this. It was like the first one I grabbed, but honestly, I'm so happy I did because it looks so pretty and pink, and you know what? You gotta love that. So if you want to make things even more fancier, go ahead, click your fingers and add a fun little background behind your envelope. Now just imagine how cool it'll be if you're showing someone else your sketchbook and then they just flip the page and they find an envelope in it. Like, that's gonna be such a cool way to just surprise them in the moment. Now as for what you put in your envelope, that is completely your choice. For example, I decided to put two cards in it, one with my achievement of December and one with my goals for this month of January in terms of YouTube and art. Now if you'd like to, you can write your goals for the year, or you can write some memories of the past year, or you can add like a small drawing that you made at some point in time, kind of like what I did in my previous sketchbook. Or you could go ahead and add photos of yourself and, you know, kind of save those memories. Or it can just be something for you and you only, because in the end it is your sketchbook and you have the complete freedom to customize it in any way you want to. And now that actually transitions well into our second technique, which is to use stickers in your sketchbook. Now you can go ahead and use pre-bought stickers such as these, you can use washi tape, or you can even make your own stickers. Personally, I love, love, love using stickers, and I love using stickers in my sketchbook because it's such a nice quick way to add like this bright pop of color in your sketchbook. Like, all you're doing is just peeling the sticker off and putting it on. It's that easy and it looks really cool as well. Now let's say that you want to make your own sticker. I've tried a bunch of different techniques over the past years when it comes to making my own stickers, and this is the one that I found works quite well for me. So what I pretty much do is I grab a piece of paper, I sketch my design, and then I color it in. That's the very first step. And you might have seen me use this technique in the video I posted last year, the second one about how I customize my sketchbook. And now once you have your drawing done, I pretty much go ahead and I cut around it, making sure to leave a tiny border just to give it that fun sticker-like effect. Then I go ahead and I grab some baking paper. I got just a tiny bit here just to demonstrate. Then I got some clear sellotape and stuck it on the baking paper. Then I smoothed it out to make sure that there are no air bubbles left. Then I placed the sticker on top and placed another layer of clear sellotape on top, making sure to smooth out all the air bubbles, or at least those ones that are close to the actual sticker. And then I left a border again around the sticker because this is where we're going to have some extra tape. And now pretty much you have got yourself a sticker. You can just peel off the baking paper like you would on a normal sticker, and your custom sticker is ready. Now yes, you can probably just draw this design directly on your sketchbook, but honestly, if you enjoy the process of making stickers, then go for it. Follow your heart, do what you want, and have lots of fun along the way. And now down to my very last method of this video when it comes to how I like to fill my sketchbooks and make it a tiny bit more interesting is to use sticky notes. And that's pretty much it. The entire technique is just to use sticky notes. You can use sticky notes directly on your sketchbook by gluing them in, you can use them to cover up other drawings, or you can use them to make something interactive. For example, over here I used sticky notes to cover up drawings that I didn't like that much. Here I used it to protect a pencil drawing, and here I just placed it there just for fun. Here's why I love using sticky notes in my sketchbook. Number one, it is such a nice way to add a nice pop of color. Number two, it gives you a nice small surface to work on if a big surface is something that might stress you out. And number three, sticky notes come in so many shapes and sizes and forms, and it's just so much fun to experiment with different ways to put them on your paper, with different ways you can use them, and different ways that you can kind of utilize them to add value to your sketchbook page. And guess what? Just like that, I was done with this sketchbook page as well. Not only was it super fun, but it also turned out looking super colorful and super unique as well. Plus, it really got me thinking outside of the box and experimenting and trying something different, which is really what sketchbooks are for. It's for you to try new stuff and express yourself. And just like that, yet again, with a snap of my finger, we have another drawing complete on the page next to this page. And with that, we are officially done with all the drawings in today's video. Here is how the blue page turned out. I did change some things, but I think the final result turned out looking pretty cool. And then here is a very nice fun page. I love filling in these types of pages where I just kind of make stuff up on the go, but it ends up looking nice and fun, and it brings back memories of all the fun I had as well. And finally, here is our fun little page with a fairy drawing. Anyways guys, that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys all have a fabulous day. Stay awesome as always, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!